Hello and welcome to the Big Picture. In an unprecedented experiment in Indian politics, the Aam Aadmi Party has gone ahead and decided to form a minority government in Delhi after a public referendum. The referendum held in the capital over the last few days, the AAP leaders claim, had clearly concluded that they should go ahead and form the government with outside support from the Congress. The party, which was seen as an upstart just a few months back, has done the unthinkable by being in a position to form the government. However, the decision has already come in for criticism from the BJP, which had emerged as the single largest party. Congress, meanwhile, despite its pledge to unconditionally support the Aam Aadmi Party in forming the government, however, seems to be singing a different tune now. The AAP leader Prashant Bhushan has interestingly expressed skepticism about how long the government would be allowed to function. All this makes for interesting developments. We will look at all this unprecedented experiment undertaken by the Aam Aadmi Party and what challenges they face now that they have decided to form the government. To discuss this, I have with me Prof. Anand, National Executive Member of the Aam Aadmi Party, Aman, Sinha, Spokesperson of the Delhi Unit of the BJP, Haroon, Yusuf, former Minister in the Delhi Government belonging to the Congress, and Sachidananda, Murthy, Resident Editor of the Week Magazine. Welcome to all of you. I would like Professor Anand Kumar, I'd like to come to you first.
Thank you.
It has been quite an unprecedented. Finally, you have taken the decision. You think that your government has now acquired legitimacy with this referendum, which you people are saying that, you know, gave you this go ahead to form the government.
See, for last 5 days, we have been waiting for this question of legitimacy. Everybody has been talking about numbers.
Yes.
And they have been talking about the relevance of this referendum which we undertook. It was because of the search of legitimacy. We had second largest number of members elected by the people of Delhi.
Right.
The first party, the largest party, was BJP, with the logical claim to be invited, and was invited, and it turned down because they said we don't have the numbers. Then we were told, you have your chance, because there is an unsolicited letter.
Yes.
From your major adversary.
Right.
And the party which has been ruling and running the city-state for last 15 years. It was a surprise for us. It was also a moral dilemma, because we had told in clear terms, samarthan nahi lenge, samarthan nahi denge.
Right.
And then, who is the trustee of this whole process? The people of Delhi. They are the sovereign. We had to go and ask them about our dilemma, whether we should go and stay away from the whole process of election and, say, government formation, because there is a need now to respond. And what do we do? We have already written letters to BJP and Congress. What is your direction for us? We shared that letter with the people. We went to all the
wards. What are the kind of response you got? 25 lakh applications.
Well, I was there in Madhyam.
But totally, how many responses did you get?
Well, in each assembly constituency, there are 4 wards, and we conducted meetings, at least one minimum in each ward. In many cases, was more than one, because there was a lot of enthusiasm as well as complexity in each assembly constituency. And there was major thrust in favor of going for a government in minority condition.
With the support of the Congress party.
Yes, and they said that, and we asked them question, that what the letter itself says, that Congress may withdraw the support on flimsy grounds, that Arvind Kejriwal is coughing too much and we don't like it. And the people said that if they do it, it will be irresponsible, and we will respond to that suitably if there is another election forced upon us.
So there is a threat on the Congress party.
Well, not really a threat, but there is already a clarity because of their history, a long shadow.
Okay, and then you think that now you're going to be forming a legitimate government.
We have.
You don't think you have no more questions of legitimacy?
Not at the moment from people's perspective, but our dear friends in Bharatiya Janata Party can always claim that this is an alliance of convenience.
We will come to, yes. In fact, alliance of convenience. Their chief ministerial candidate says that you have betrayed the people of Delhi.
At least we have betrayed his hopes.
We have betrayed his hopes. Let me get Haroon Yusuf in on this, because Haroon Yusuf is going to be supporting the Aam Aadmi Party government. Mr. Yusuf, the question of your party supporting the Aam Aadmi Party as an unconditional. First, you said that it's going to be unconditional support. You gave a letter to the Lieutenant General, Lieutenant Governor, saying that, you know, you're giving unconditional support. Now we are hearing a different tune from Sheila Dikshit, who says that, you know, it is not unconditional. What are you trying to do?
No. You see, from the very beginning, the letter given by our AICC General Secretary,
yes,
it was clearly mentioned that Congress is ready to give outside support.
Right.
And we have party has taken the stand because we were not wanting another election for the people of Delhi. It will be an additional burden. And the promises which Aam Aadmi Party has made to the people of Delhi, that they will reduce power tariff, power bills by 50%, 700 liters free water per day to our family.
Mr. Yusuf,
hello.
No, we will come to those
and
promises.
They but promised my,
no, but Mr.
So
Yusuf,
many other
my, Mr. Yusuf, my question, direct question is, you said first that you will give unconditional support. Now you are saying that it is not unconditional. What is the meaning of this?
No. The letter is with the Honorable Lieutenant Governor, and it is clearly mentioned there that we are ready to give outside support to the Aam Aadmi Party,
right,
to form the government and fulfill the promises they have made in their manifesto.
So are you trying to say that in the letter to the Lieutenant Governor, which your General Secretary of the AICC gave, the word unconditional was not present?
No, it was not mentioned at all.
It was not mentioned.
It was very clear that it will be the outside support.
Okay, let me get Mr. Anand Kumar. Professor Anand Kumar, now they are saying that they didn't mention the word unconditional.
Sir, the letter
did
is...
Did you presume that it was unconditional?
No, the letter is in the custody of Honorable Lieutenant Governor. What we heard through the voices and faces of Congress spokesperson, ranging from Shri Shakil Ahmed to a couple of other people down the line, it was unconditional till we started referendum. Now, Sheila ji, the architect of Congress party in Delhi for last 15 years and one of the most seasoned politicians in that party, has come out with a different tune today. And Haroon Sahab, of course, as a loyal soldier of Sheila ji's army and a wounded soldier, has to follow what the lady is saying.
Wounded soldier, you, Haroon Yusuf?
No. I'm sorry to say that from the very beginning, we are saying, and I had been saying it on various channels, that we are giving outside support to the party.
No, outside,
and in
everybody
case of
knew,
outside support.
I don't think there
no
was any,
con-
Mr. Yusuf, there was no there, confusion as far as outside support was concerned.
There cannot be any no confidence motion for 6 months.
No, there was no confusion as far as your outside support was concerned. The only confusion now is whether it's conditional or unconditional. I'll come back to you. Let me get Aman Sinha in on this. Aman Sinha, your party, being the single largest party, still was not able to form the government. Is it an issue of sour grapes, because all your leaders seems to be now attacking the Aam Aadmi Party, calling it a betrayal? You had an opportunity to form the government, you didn't. And now why are you people, you know, grudging Aam Aadmi Party forming a government?
No, as you can see, whether it is Aam Aadmi Party or Congress, they have been changing their stands all through this electoral exercise. BJP is the only party which has held a consistent stand. Since we did not get to majority mark, we very, you know, in a very dignified manner, very respectfully, we stayed out of that. However, the fact remains that Aam Aadmi Party and all its leaders, you know, they were all saying that since their politics is based on, you know, vehement opposition of Congress and BJP, therefore, at no point in time, they are going to give
they
or take support.
They
but
have taken
now,
the, now,
since,
now the referendum. They have
yes,
taken
yes.
a referendum.
No, please, you know, this is nowhere near a referendum. If you refer to, you know, any good dictionary, even Oxford Dictionary says that referendum is of entire electorate. And, you know, you cannot become a judge in your own referendum. And somebody has to evaluate and decipher the referendum. You cannot, you know, decipher, you know, your own prospects and results. Now, even going by their figures and presuming that were to be correct, you know, the referendum is only of about 1% electorate. And what better referendum than elections that we had? You know, just week back we had election results. And what can be a, you know, a bit better barometer than that? The results were clear. BJP was the single largest party in terms of seats as well as votes. Aam Aadmi Party got about 28% votes, and 72% of electorate was not in favor of Aam Aadmi. The bulk of the 28% vote was bitterly anti-Congress vote. Now they have made a somersault. They have gone and formed an unholy alliance with the Congress.
They are
entitled to their stand.
But what
I am saying is
yes.
that they have to be answerable for what they are doing, because this kind of shifting and changing of stand and somersault.
Of course, they'll be answerable. So what you are saying is two things. One is that this referendum is a non-referendum, according to you.
No, absolutely, according to anyone.
And second thing is, when you are saying this, that means that you didn't want any government to be formed. You wanted another election.
You see, as far as government formation is concerned, this is between Aam Aadmi Party and Congress Party.
You have to answer this.
We have nothing to do with that. We are not in business of supporting A party or B party.
Right.
So we are working in the best interest of people of Delhi, whether we are in opposition or we are in government.
The best interest of the people in Delhi, you think, would have been served better if you had gone for a re-election.
As far as we were concerned, since we did not have the majority mark, we, in a very dignified manner, we stayed out. Please tell me one party which was, just 2-3 seats short of a majority mark and would not be hankering to form the government. Only BJP could have done it.
Yes, BJP could have done it, because obviously there was a pressure on you not to indulge in certain things which we have seen earlier in the past. Luckily, we didn't see that.
This kind of all these tactics is all Congress Party, and my good friend Haroon Yusuf was saying that only for saving electorate from an election they have entered into an alliance. Governments have been pulled down by Congress Party.
That's a different
and
matter.
Maximum number that of elections have been opposed by Congress only.
Mr. Aman Sinha, the issue is that did the BJP want a re-election or not? You are not willing to commit yourself on that.
No, we are not for re-election. But if that were to happen, let it happen. What could we do?
Okay. Sachi, yes, you think Mr. Anand Kumar says that after this referendum they have acquired legitimacy. Aman Sinha says this is a non-referendum. Sure. Haroon Yusuf is saying that they had only offered outside support and not unconditional support.
I think Girish, on the high moral ground, you cannot give full marks to the Aam Aadmi Party.
You can't,
because they say our spokesman said that, yes, they said samarthan nahi lenge, nahi denge. Then you have claimed down from that high horse.
Okay.
And I agree that a referendum like this is not something which may satisfy you, is a fig leaf for the party. But from a political sense, it's the right decision.
Right.
I think that this is where, they've taken a leaf out of Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, who formed a minority government of 13 days, knowing very well that he had no majority. At least here, AAP knows that the Congress will support them Mr. Haroon Yusuf let out the cat saying that for 6 months at least there will be no confidence motion.
Yes.
So Mr. Haroon Yusuf, I think his party needs 6 months to recover. So they will not destabilize this government for 6 months. That's the initial intention. And then in this 6 months or 4 months, whatever the time Mr. Kejriwal and his team get, if they can get some of those populist promises they have made off their chest, start implementing them. Cut the electricity prices. The dramatic way some chief ministers have signed files immediately after taking oath, cutting the price of rice, cutting the introducing prohibition and all that. So Mr. Kejriwal can make those grand gestures the day he becomes a chief minister.
Okay.
But then Aman Sinha also was saying that Congress keeps pulling down and all that. But the BJP, the last major BJP government which came without a majority,
Karnataka.
They were shot, if you remember, Girish, again by 3 seats for a majority.
Karnataka,
they launched an operation voters to buy MLAs.
Absolutely.
And they suffered very badly because of that immoral thing.
Right up till Supreme Court.
Operation Lotus was not a very dignified
way of getting
this thing.
I don't know which operation you are mentioning about.
Anyway,
but right now, there is an unholy operation.
Let us not go back. But the fact is that history can't be forgotten. Professor Anand Kumar, the fact now is, Prashant Bhushan says that we don't know how long we are going to last. I don't know how long Congress is going to. Why this kind of sarcastic or skeptical remarks when you are about to form a government, a historic government in this? Are you preparing ground or are you very uncomfortable forming this government?
No, there is some kind of, inner anxiety Because Congress, as we saw,
inner anxiety, is it just because just about the how the Congress would behave, or is it about the inner anxiety is because you just don't have anybody in your part 20 among the 28 MLAs who have had any experience in any manner of running a government?
No. That anxiety is not there, because we have the precedence of people ranging from Jawaharlal Nehru to Sri Atal Bihari Vajpayee not running any government. Actually, Jawaharlal Ji, Sardar Patel, Monala Azad walked out of prison and moved into centers of power.
Yes.
Atal Ji was sitting most of his life in opposition benches. Didn't have any deputy minister's experience. But then he became foreign minister and did serve with distinction. No, that's not the anxiety, because our team is led by some of the most educated people in technology, law, medicine, many other branches of knowledge. Our anxiety is about Congress Party. If Congress Party is changing and becoming reliable, is going to do better than what they did with Charan Singh, Chandrasekhar, Dev Gowda, Gujral, Pattam Thanu Pillai, the country will be happy, Delhi will be happy, of course we'll be the happiest. But if they don't do it, what can we do? So Prashanti is being honest and transparent.
Haroon Yusuf. So that the onus seems to be entirely on the Congress Party to ensure that the Aam Aadmi Party government will last for five years.
Categorically.
Yes.
You see, we have very categorically said that till the time they'll keep on fulfilling the promises made in the manifesto to the people of Delhi, we'll support them, we'll stand by them.
Thank you, Arun. Thank you very much.
Then the Congress will think about it.
So you will closely monitor the implementation of the manifesto or promises which they have made.
We are supporting.
So, okay.
Yes, we will be monitoring it very closely.
Scam and host of other, electricity and water related scams, which were part of the manifesto of the Aam Aadmi Party. Let us see what they deliver, because they have been, speaking and saying about lot many things. It is all very fine to say that, you are pious, you are, divine, and rest everybody is corrupt. But however, you have to deliver,
really,
and let us see.
Aman Sinha, you people really seem to be, posing a challenge to them to show that they are as pious as you put it.
It has been their consistent stand. In fact, their party leader also.
You seem to be enjoying, posing these challenges now.
No, we enjoy each and every challenge that comes our way. But our duty is towards the people of Delhi, and we work in the best interest of people of Delhi, whether we sit in power or in opposition. However, at the same time, their leaders have been saying that we will send Congress and BJP to jail, and getting
not
into
Congress
all this.
Congress and BJP, the corrupt people.
This is what your leader said.
People, we will not send any Congress person.
Your leader did not qualify. I'm Mr. Professor Anand Kumar is a very renowned academician, and he can, qualify things. But his leader, Mr. Kejriwal, he just said that we will put Congress and BJP into jail. Now, what is the point that you're trying to make? This kind of arrogance and this kind of language is, today you have not even taken oath, but just imagine the kind of arrogance that you have, arrogated yourself.
Watch whether what you call as arrogance or, will he be able to what?
And just one short point on referendum, if I may say. Referendum has been, widely misused even by people like, Hitler and Mussolini, Indira Gandhi also. From after World War, after World War II, therefore, referendum has never been, instituted back in Germany. Even Indira Gandhi also, she said that she had popular sanction for emergency, and she imposed emergency.
It is very interesting.
So therefore, these things are all very misleading.
Aman Sinha, it's very interesting that you quote Mussolini and Hitler in this context.
Yes.
Very interesting. Sache? Let us keep Aman Sinha's doubts
the
and
point
concerns
that I'm making
aside,
is that you cannot, in guise of referendum, you cannot, just meet your own self-serving political interests.
It's okay. The people should decide. Sachi, the biggest challenge posed to the Aam Aadmi Party now. What would be the, they have made several promises, all populist promises actually, if you look at it.
Yeah.
You think that the onus will be now on the Congress Party to ensure that this government survives?
No. The onus will not be on the Congress. It will be on how
the, you know, Aam Aadmi Party's leadership handles the promises it has made, take on the day-to-day administration, implement its non-controversial promises easily. But when it comes to those controversial promises, suppose they say that we are ordering a Lokayukta or a CBI inquiry into the corruption cases against the previous Congress government, then how will the Congress take it? So, and will, you know, will Kejriwal go and talk to the Congress leaders, because he has kept himself away from all of them. So, as a chief minister, as a leader of a ruling party, how will he behave? All those things will come. He now he has to swallow a lot of the words he has said if he wants to carry on running the government. So,
okay.
Is he going to maximize whatever chance he has got now, build on this, build a foundation for a good victory, or will he fritter it away by, you know, trying to hit at too many windmills? So, that right. We have to see.
So, yeah. Haroon Yusuf, the, you know, whatever, we come back to the same question, whatever, wherever we go, that the onus will be now on the Congress party, how long it wants this government to continue. Because as Sachidananda Murthy rightly pointed, let me finish, Mr. Yusuf. Like Sachidananda Murthy rightly points out, you know, you were talking about implementation of the promises which Aam Aadmi has made. One of the promises they have made is to inquire about the what has happened in the Commonwealth Games. You think that is something which you people will allow them to do?
You see, number one, the onus lies with the Aam Aadmi Party, because they have promised too many things to the people of Delhi. As far as the inquiries are concerned, Congress is not bothered about it. You remember the Shunglu Committee report?
Yes.
The Chief Minister has replied paragraph by paragraph, and that report has been submitted to the Shunglu Committee.
So you think that there is no more
reply?
No, you think
and
that
nothing has come out.
One second, Mr. Yusuf.
The Congress Party and our leader, Srimati Sonia Ji, Suresh Kalmadi was put in jail, Raja was put in jail. That is how our Congress Party works.
So, Mr.
They were all put in jail by the courts. Not by the Congress Party. The
Congress Party can't put people in jail. Your party also can't put people in jail.
That's not my friend.
One minute. Mr. Yusuf, are you then trying to say that there is no need for any further inquiry as far as Commonwealth Games issue is concerned?
No, I'm not saying that. I am saying Congress is not scared of any inquiry.
Okay, Congress is not scared of inquiry.
If we were scared of something like this, we wouldn't have come out to support the Aam Aadmi Party.
So you know what you're up against.
We are supporting them to fulfill their promises.
So you know what you're up against, Mr. Professor Anand Kumar. You have got a clean chit saying that you go ahead and do whatever inquiries you want. They will not be bothered.
Well, I wish that a senior leader like Haroon Saab is the president of Delhi Pradesh Congress Committee, rather than the present leader, who is trying to scare us by telling us that behave and
if he says that
they are not worried about the need of inquiring into acts of omission and commission of the last couple of years, that gives us a happy sleep tonight. Because everybody has been asking us, like you did, that you have promised that you will inquire into the acts of omission by the BJP government and Congress government in municipality and Delhi. What will happen to you? Are they going to allow you? Haroon Saab says, why not? Go ahead.
Yes.
We are clean and correct. Go and inquire about it. We will appoint a committee to look into the price jacking by the private companies of electricity.
I
think that they will agree with that.
So, you know,
we are going to have
you're going to appoint a committee. You're not going to, you know, you have promised
Girish,
that you cut prices by 50%.
We are going to, see, BJP had said it is
one
possible
second, Sachi.
30% can be brought down. Congress own expert committee had said 25% has been jacked up unnecessarily. So there is a gray area. And that gray area has to be addressed by us, by qualified people, and we are going to deliver it. BJP would have also delivered
700 liters of water.
Water mafia. Either water mafia is there, or there is a water system. Water mafia must be in jail, and water must be in our water taps.
Yes, Sachi.
Hello, Girish, I want to ask both Professor and Mr. Yusuf, has there been any talks between the Aam Aadmi Party and the Congress? Is there an understanding? Is there an informal deal between them?
Murthy Saab, it has been only through our common friends, that is the fourth pillar of democracy. We are talking through these mediators and matchmakers.
We are yet to meet
face to face. And in that meeting, we would like to have our loyal opposition also.
In the Ramayana,
the opposition will always be loyal to the people of Delhi. But however, one point, that since you know our friend's party is the most transparent party, why these secret dealings? What is your understanding with your Congress party? What are the conditions? Our friend is saying that there are certain conditions on which support has been given. Our friend Professor Kumar is saying that they are talking through some intermediaries.
That is the media.
Why? No, you are not talking through media.
He said you
are talking through your friends.
Through media.
Why don't you bring that in public domain? Why are you saying that is all
you say? First you say that they are the most transparent party, then you are raising this question.
Oh yes, obviously, because they have to live up to the standards that they have set for themselves.
Mr. Yusuf, has there been any discussions? Let us get this clear from your side also. Has there been any secret meetings? Has there been any discussions?
There was no discussion. We had given a letter, our party has given a letter to the Honorable Lieutenant Governor of Delhi.
Yes.
And mentioning in that we are ready to give outright support to the Aam Aadmi Party so that they are able to fulfill all the promises they have made to the people of Delhi.
Okay, so there has been no secret understanding.
No, it's remarkable in today's age of instant communication. One party who was bitterly fighting against another, they extend support and they say that there has been no communication. And if this is the way the government is also going to work, then
Professor Anand,
we are all in hands of God.
Aman Sinha seems to think that you people are having some secret understanding. He thinks that you are having secret understanding.
No, there is an open understanding of being a speed breaker to the forces.
That
which
we all see in the house when the assembly meets.
Yes, please complete. He's saying
an open understanding with the people of India to be a speed breaker for the forces of crony capitalism, communalism and corruption at high places.
So therefore my friend is saying Aam Aadmi Party and Congress are, they are in an alliance just to stop the BJP from coming to power.
BJP represents
Mr.
Aman Sinha,
this is what you are alluding to, I guess.
You are already preparing the ground for your battle against these people. We can see that. But anyway,
us can see they are all hand in glove together.
Okay, now that the government of the Aam Aadmi Party has become a reality, it's a matter of time before they will go ahead and form the government. We will wait and watch. There will be a lot of promises made here. Today, we have heard both the Congress Party spokesman and the Aam Aadmi spokesman openly admitting that, they have not had any understanding. They have openly admitting that they will function as much as well as possible. We'll see how this government will function. I'm sure the BJP will be taking a very close look at how they function. The whole of Delhi and the whole of India will also see how they will function. Thanks to all my guests, Haroon Yusuf, Prof. Anand Kumar, Aman Sinha and Sachidananda Murthy. Please keep watching. We'll come back with another issue in Big Picture same time tomorrow.